These retro Domestic Diva kits are great for crafting, cooking, or the next time you entertain friends. There's a Domestic Diva style for everyone. Hi, I'm Tara, but I'm feeling like a Jacqueline today. Everything's included on one panel, even the instructions. First, cut out all the separate pieces. We're cutting around the notch marks. We'll need these marks later to match up the pieces. We cut around these notches so we can match the notch on the flounce to the notch on the apron. Then, with right sides together, we start to pin. Now stitch the flounce to the apron. There are many ways to finish the seams. Today I'm choosing a simple zigzag. Finish the outside edges with a 1/4 inch turn under and top stitch. Now let's add the pocket. The fold point is clearly marked with a little black arrow. Fold in half and pin. Stitch a 1/4 inch seam allowance from one folded edge to about 1 inch before the next folded edge. This 1 inch opening will allow us to turn the pocket right side out. After pressing, pick a spot for your pocket and stitch it on. For reference, each Domestic Diva package has an illustration showing the completed apron, including the pocket. The last step is to make the ties. Fold them in half, lengthwise, right sides together, and pin. Stitch along the long side. At the end, pivot and turn. Continue on to one short side. Repeat this for all the ties. Turn them all right side out and press. Pin the open ends of the necktie to the top of the apron. Then pin the open ends of the waist tie to the sides of the apron. Then sew them on. Here's my finished apron. Now it's your turn to decide which diva to make, or maybe all of them.
For every event or idea, whether you're an eager beginner or a seasoned crafter, you'll be amazed at what you can do when you